Let's talk about the contenders and the pretenders for the top four this season in the Premier League. Now, Liverpool and Man City should be locks. What we've seen so far, the questions remain for Manchester City, but it is early days and there's still plenty of games to be played, but top four for sure. But we've put together a list for Mark Ogden to see what he thinks, and maybe we've thrown a few surprises in there. So I'll start, Mark, with Leicester City.
Well, Leicester flying the best start they've ever made to a Premier League season, three straight wins. We know that they've got that ability to win the Premier League when they surprised everybody by doing it in 2016. The one downside with Leicester is that they really tailed off in the second half of last season. They were nailed uncertainties for the top four for the Champions League spot in February, you know, January, February, but they let it slide after the restart. So you'd have to question Leicester's ability to stay the course, but maybe they've learnt from last season. Maybe they've developed that toughness that they need to get over the line. So I think, for me, Leicester are the best hope of anyone outside the so-called Big Six to break into the top four.
I wonder what your thoughts are on Everton with everything we've seen so far. It seems to all be working under Carlo Ancelotti. James seems to be fitting in really well there. What will they finish in position-wise at the end of the season?
I think Everton have been a real surprise. They have got some tough games coming up and they do play Liverpool, I think, after the international break. So they play Liverpool at Goodison Park. That, for me, that is a real test of their, you know, potential. They haven't beaten Liverpool at Goodison Park for 10 years. They haven't beaten them at Anfield since 1999. So they really are overdue a win against Liverpool. If they win that game, then all of a sudden you can maybe start talking at Everton as a contender for top four. The one concern I'd have at Everton is the goalkeeper, Jordan Pickford. I just don't think he's good enough. Yes, he's the England goalkeeper. He had a great World Cup in 2018. But since 2018, I think he's been on a downward slope. He's just, he doesn't give any confidence to the team. He makes a lot of mistakes. And you can't win anything with an average goalkeeper or a poor goalkeeper. And I think Pickford is Everton's weak link. And if he continues to make the mistakes we've already seen this season, then he could be the difference between Everton finishing the European places, even the top four, or missing out. So if I was Carlo Ancelotti, what I'd be doing right now is trying to find a reliable top-class goalkeeper before the deadline.
Okay. Top four is something that we always talked about when it comes to Arsenal. Obviously, they're under a different coach to Arsene Wenger now, and Mikel Arteta. But what do you see when it comes to their chances this season?
I was at the game on Monday when they went to Liverpool and lost 3-1. And, you know, they made a good start, took the lead. The one thing with Arsenal is that it is all about Aubameyang. If Aubameyang's fit and scoring goals, they've got a chance. But everything revolves around them. And, I was thinking the other day, is any team in the world so reliant on one player as Arsenal are with Aubameyang? And you can probably say that Barcelona, Lionel Messi, and that is it. If Aubameyang isn't fit and playing, Arsenal have got problems because the defence isn't brilliant. Midfield lacks a bit of creativity, but if Aubameyang stays fit, they've got a chance because Arteta's made them organised. He's got that kind of confidence back and belief back. But they have got problems, Arsenal. But Aubameyang does make a big difference. He papers over the cracks a lot, but he's got to stay fit. And that is the big thing for Arsenal, keeping him fit.
Manchester United, there was a lot of excitement and expectation before the season began. After the games we've seen so far, it's hard to tell right now, but what do you think?
Well, they made that terrible start against Crystal Palace, losing on the opening day. The transfer business has been abysmal this summer, hasn't it? They brought in Donny van der Beek. I do expect them to bring in at least one more player before the transfer deadline, but it's not enough. You know, they've had all summer to strengthen the squad. They really look like they needed strengthening when they lost to Sevilla in the Europa League semi-final. But they haven't brought enough players in and they haven't got enough players out. You know, there's a lot of players at United that has been there for too long, that they've got no future there, and they've taken far too long. So whatever they do now at United, whether they bring people in or get rid of people, it looks like a panic or a last-minute measure or something that's just come up. It doesn't look strategic or planned. So I do worry for United. I think that the best they can hope for this season is fourth. And, you know, they finished third last season. But I do think that because they haven't strengthened where they need to and because there's still question marks over Paul Pogba's kind of usefulness in that team with Bruno Fernandes and Donny van der Beek, I do think United are basically playing for fourth.
Okay. Tottenham Hotspur brought back one of their most famous players, probably the biggest player in the Premier League right now, in Gareth Bale. Have to wait to see him when he's fit, but could he make a difference for them this season?
Yeah, Gareth Bale can make a big difference. They need to score more goals and they need to be more threatening, and he will bring that if he stays fit. And that is the thing with Gareth Bale, if he stays fit, he's not even fit yet. You know, he's come from Real Madrid and he's still not fit. So, you know, you have to question mark how many games he'll play, but he will make a difference. So Tottenham are a strange club because there's a big question mark over Dele Alli's future right now. Does Mourinho want him to stay? Does he want him to go? What is the issue there? Nobody seems to know. I do worry about Tottenham a little bit. I do think that they're very unpredictable under Mourinho. And I'm just not sure they have the depth that they need to finish in the top four. So I think, like Man United, I think Spurs are a team that can aim for fourth, but not much higher.
Chelsea, that's an interesting one right now, because maybe we expected them to start the season a bit stronger than they have.
Yeah, and I don't think any manager in the Premier League is under more pressure right now than Frank Lampard, because, you know, he's been given that checkbook this summer, £220 million. I think he spent maybe a bit more now. They signed Mendy, and I think, you know, they started poorly. That the defeat against Liverpool, the draw against West Brom, where they came back from the dead, to be fair, to get a point, but they brought a lot of people in, and they will expect a challenge for the title. You know, they spent over £200 million, so they'll have to challenge. But for me, they look a bit unbalanced. You know, Kai Havertz, Timo Werner, Hakim Ziyech, they're all attacking players. They need better quality at the back. And, you know, Thiago Silva made an unconvincing debut at West Brom. The goalkeeper situation, we still have to wait and see if Mendy's the solution. So there are a lot of question marks over Chelsea, but on paper, they should be challenging Man City and Liverpool at the top. But in reality, they're, you know, third and fourth is the best they can do.
We've thrown a cheeky one in just because they've brought the entertainment so far. It's Leeds United.
Yeah, I mean, look, who knows with Leeds? I mean, I was at the game against Liverpool on the opening day of the season. I expected Liverpool to win that quite easily, and it turned out to be very, very close, because Leeds just wouldn't take no for an answer. They wouldn't lie down, and they kept going at Liverpool. They scored a lot of goals. They will score a lot of goals, but they'll also concede a lot of goals as well. And yeah, it's fantastic to see Leeds back in the Premier League, and it's just a shame that Elland Road isn't full of fans and making the noise that they will bring to the Premier League. But I think the priority for Leeds even now is to stay up. You know, they spent 16 years out of the Premier League, and it's been a long time for the club. They need some stability. If they finish top six, top seven, fantastic. But if they finish top 10, that's a great season for Leeds. Yeah, let's hope that they can sustain it. But I think it will level off, and I think they'll be happy with the top half of the table finish.
I'll put last season's top two in together here then. Liverpool and Man City, we expect them, of course, to finish in the top four. But do you think Man City are the only true challengers to Liverpool's throne this season?
I don't think there are any challengers to Liverpool's crown this season. Honestly, I was at the game on the Monday, and I thought that Liverpool showed that they are still a long way ahead of everybody else. I think the only team that can stop Liverpool this season is Liverpool themselves. You know, if complacency sets in, you know, there were times when they defensively they weren't fantastic, but they work so hard, you know, that they're the best team in the country, one of the best teams in Europe. And every time they lose the ball, they work so hard to get it back. You don't see that in any other team. And Man City, obviously, they've got big problems because they conceded 5 goals at home to Leicester. I just don't see anybody competing with Liverpool this season. I really don't. I think City have got to be careful. They've spent £100 million now on centre-halves this summer, and they still can't keep the ball at the back of the net. So maybe City isn't nailed on for top two. You know, City could fall back into the pack while Liverpool just pull away from the rest and win the title again.
I was just going to ask you that then, just to end. If you are to give a top four now, just from what you've seen, who would you say?
I'd say Liverpool will finish top by some distance. I think that despite my concerns for City, I think that City will finish in the top four. I think Leicester will finish top four. And I think after that, I can't separate Man United and Tottenham and Chelsea. I don't think Arsenal will be there. I'm going to say Man United because I do think they might have a rabbit they can pull out of the sleeve before the transfer deadline. But, you know, United, Spurs, Chelsea, Arsenal, it's anyone at four for fourth place, I think.
It looks like we're in for quite the ride ahead when it comes to the top four places this season in the Premier League.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. And for more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for premium content and live streaming, subscribe to ESPN+.